국가 간의 이동이 늘어나며 세계 기업가들은 이전보다 훨씬 긴밀하게 연결되고 있습니다. 시장을 확대할 기회가 그만큼 커진 것입니다. 하지만 비즈니스에서 서로 다른 언어와 문화는 여전히 높은 장벽입니다. 외국어를 공부하는 글로벌 최고 경영자는 이 장벽을 넘어 소통할 준비가 되어 있어야 합니다. 모국어가 아닌 다른 언어를 말할 수 있는 능력은 새로운 파트너와 소통할 수 있는 기회를 넓혀주고 이는 다시 잠재적인 소비자와 시장에 대한 접근성을 높이게 됩니다. 전문가들은 또 여러 가지 언어를 말하는 기업가는 그렇지 않은 기업가보다 훨씬 창의적이라고 말합니다. 언어는 우리의 사고방식을 결정하고 다른 언어를 습득한다는 것은 새로운 사고방식을 얻었다는 의미입니다. 글로벌 컨설팅사 맥킨지는 글로벌화가 더 빠르게 진전될수록 더 많은 사람이 해외에서 일하고 다문화 가정에서 태어나는 아이들도 더 늘어날 것이라며 이런 환경에서 창출되는 새로운 수요를 포착하는 능력은 매우 큰 장점이라고 분석했습니다. 그러면서 맥킨지는 두 개 이상의 언어를 구사하는 CEO는 이런 시장 환경에 더 능동적으로 대처할 수 있다고 하는데요. 그래서 이번 시간에는 젊은 CEO들의 영어 능력을 확인해보는 시간을 가져보겠습니다. 첫 번째로 쿠팡 대표이사 김범석입니다. 김범석은 1978년 10월 7일 서울에서 태어났고 대기업 주재원이던 아버지를 따라 어린 시절 대부분을 해외에서 보냈습니다. 중학교 때 미국으로 유학을 떠나 명문 사립학교인 디어필드 아카데미를 졸업하고 하버드대 정치학과와 하버드 비즈니스 스쿨 MBA를 졸업했습니다. 소프트뱅크로부터 천문학적인 규모의 투자 유치를 하며 쿠팡의 미래 가치를 증명해 보였지만 여전히 쿠팡을 지속 가능성을 보여줘야 하는 시험대에 서 있는 상황입니다만 이번 영상에서는 CEO의 영어 능력에만 초점을 두고 보도록 하겠습니다. 용어도 들으면서 그들의 사업 방향의 세계관을 들어보도록 하겠습니다.
There'd been this nagging feeling for months where we had to be honest with ourselves and said, yeah. Once you go public, it's much harder to really change your direction. And what was the platform we had built? Were the services and experiences that we're providing for our customers creating a 5% difference, or were we creating that kind of world where the customers we loved, you know, their jaws would drop? And the reality was no. If we wanted to provide something that really mattered to customers, we had to go through an enormous amount of change. Mm. We had to change our entire technology stack, the way we did business, our business model.
Right. That's a bold move when you're on the crux of an IPO.
It was very, very difficult. And I think that was the most difficult, but the choice that I'm most proud of. The only models that we had seen were primarily like that of Amazon, which had built out an impressive fulfillment infrastructure, but had relied in large part to very advanced infrastructure that had been built out by the U.S. Postal Service. And at the time, we really envied that. So we built, again, not only a fulfillment infrastructure, but the largest directly controlled fleet of trucks and drivers to deliver those products in multiple ways throughout the day. So what seemed like a curse at that time, that we had to build this entire infrastructure and build the technology to integrate it all, end-to-end by ourselves from scratch, ended up becoming a huge blessing. Fresh lobster, we actually have breakfast foods as well. But if you have a birthday, you can get a cake in the morning. If your printer's run out of ink, or you need a new computer, you can get a computer before 7 a.m. We realized that most customers were ordering at night. And if they wanted more selection delivered to them faster, the best experience would be if they could order it before they go to bed, wake up, and find it in front of the door.
It's like Christmas.
It's magical. the environment that Korea has, the high urbanization, the extreme population density, and the IT infrastructure, those are things that I think will be shared by customers in many areas, many regions, especially in Asia as they modernize. I don't know if I can tell you that 6 months from now or 6 years from now that we will look, you know, similar to what we look today.
Okay.
But I can tell you that we will always be a company, a technology company, that is trying to leverage what we can from human ingenuity mm-hmm. and technology to obsess about some aspect of customers' lives that we want to improve exponentially. That will be a constant.
다음은 수연의 남자이자 2019년 10월까지 위워크 코리아 제너럴 매니저였던 차민근 씨의 영어 실력을 보도록 하겠습니다.
WeWork provides them a great office environment, saves them on the build-out costs, low deposits, but as well as the ability to use any of the spaces that we have around Korea or around the world for their teams. There are WeWork locations in all the different cities where companies are forming their offices. So we're working with them to help them have a place for their teams in no matter what city they're going to. And as they also travel, they can use the WeWork locations. I think we really do believe that if you help people make new friends, friends will go out of their way to help their friends. And so you're going to build all these very strong business connections by being a part of the WeWork community. And the last part of it, I think, is us working with them to really hear what their goals are as a company and figure out how we can help them achieve that, right? Whether that's from finding other companies within WeWork to market to, work with, invest in, or partner with, to putting on events to connect with new types of individuals or companies or organizations that they're looking to expand their business in unique and creative ways.
다음은 콘텐츠 사업을 중심에 있는 박진영 프로듀서가 2018년 Macquarie Emerging Industry Summit에서 발표한 내용 일부를 들어보도록 하겠습니다.
And to be more honest with you, the reason I came here today was my friends at Macquarie told me that if I do this event, our stock price tomorrow will skyrocket. First, it's been a while. It's been over 20 years since I started this company. Back then, it wasn't really an industry. It was just more about my passion, love for the music, and trying to help other guys who have talent. But more and more, I started doing this, building this career, it actually became a company. And now it's actually bigger than me, bigger than us. It's influencing all the kids around the globe. Creativity from happiness. Especially in the creative business, I don't believe working hours give you great results. It's all about ideas, brilliant ideas. I need my artists, my producers, my musicians, and my employees to come up with brilliant ideas. So how can that happen? If my employees are tired and exhausted, how can they come up with great ideas? So the last theme, but the most important theme, is trying to take care of our employees, make them in the best condition they can ever be.